Today we will learn about a new topic in mathematics, and that is mensuration. But before that, again I would like to tell you that never forget to subscribe the channel. Your subscription is very valuable for the channel. Your subscription, your views and your comments are very valuable. Don't break the chain. Let the chain go on, and the more you will comment, the more we will realize our mistakes and try to make you understand much more things and give much more knowledge by rectifying the mistakes in the comment box. So always remember, before viewing or after viewing, subscribe, give your likes and give your comments. Your comments are most valuable for me, and your subscription is more valuable for the channel. So I myself, Kunna, for Kunna's Horizon, want to teach you now something about mensuration in mathematics. The topic is mensuration. Before giving you some before telling you something about mensuration, first I would like to tell you something about the units of mensuration. So, number one, some units, common units. Common units of mensuration. Some common units of mensuration. Common units of perimeter are meter, centimeter, centimeter and decimeter, etc. So number one, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter, and 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meters. 1 by 100 meters is equal to 0.01 meters. Next one, number two is 1 meter. 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter is equal to 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meters. Similarly, 1 meter, 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeter. Therefore, and 1 decimeter is equal to 1 by 10 meters. 1 by 10 meters. This is equal to 0.1 meters. Then the next one is 1 decimeter, number 3. 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter, 10 centimeter, and 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter is equal to 1/10 decimeter, decimeter, that is equal to 0.1 decimeter. Then number four, 1 meter, 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter, and 1 millimeter is equal to 1/1000 meter. So this is equal to 0.001 meters. 0.001 meters. Then number, this one was the first one. Number two, common units of area are square meter. Common units of area are square meter. Square meter, square meter, square centimeter, square centimeter, square decimeter, square decimeter, and square millimeter, square millimeter. So the number one is 1 meter square. 1 meter square is equal to 100 into 100 is equal to 10,000 centimeter square, 10,000 centimeter square, and 1 centimeter square is equal to 1/10,000 meter square, that is equal to 0.0001 meter square. Number one. Number two. Number two. 1 meter square. 1 meter square is equal to 10 into 10. That is equal to 100 decimeter square. And 1 decimeter square is equal to 1/100 meter square. This is equal to 0.001 meter square. 0.01 meter, 0.01 meter square. Then number three, 1 decimeter square is equal to 10 into 10 centimeter square. That is equal to 100 centimeter square, and 1 centimeter square, centimeter square is equal to 1/100 decimeter square. Then number four is 1 centimeter square is equal to 10 into 10 millimeter square. 10 into 10 millimeter square. This is equal to 100 millimeter square and 1 millimeter square is equal to 1/100 centimeter square. This is equal to 0.01 centimeter square and so on. So these are some of the common units. Common units for perimeter are meter. Common units for perimeter are meters, meter, centimeter and decimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter and 1 centimeter is equal to 1/100 meters is equal to 0.01 meters. 1 meter is 10 decimeter and 1 decimeter is equal to 1/10 meters is equal to 0.1 meters. 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter and 1 centimeter is equal to 1/10 decimeter is equal to 0.1 decimeter. 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter and 1 millimeter is equal to 1/1000 meters is equal to 0.001 meters. Common units for area are square meters, square centimeter, square decimeter and square millimeter. That is 1 meter square is equal to 100 into 100 is equal to 10,000 centimeter square and 1 centimeter square is equal to 1/10,000 meter square is equal to 0.0001 meter square. Then 1 meter square is equal to 10 into 10 100 decimeter and 1 decimeter is equal to 1/100 meter square is equal to 0.01 meter square. 1 decimeter square is equal to 10 into 10 centimeter square is equal to 100 centimeter square is equal to 1 centimeter square is equal to 1/100 decimeter square. 1 centimeter square is equal to 10 into 10 millimeter square is equal to 100 millimeter square and 1 millimeter square is equal to 1/100 centimeter square is equal to 0.01 centimeter square. So these are the some of the common units for perimeter and area in case of the two dimensional shapes. So now we will learn about what do you mean by perimeter. Perimeter means means the length of the boundary of a given figure. Perimeter means length of the boundary of a given figure. Then and what do you mean by area? Area means the space occupied the amount of surface enclosed by the sides sides of a given figure Now next one is this is known as area. So next one, first of all, what do you mean by formulas? Number one, the area enclosed by three sides is known as triangle, is known as triangle. So this is a triangle. So this is a triangle. Triangles are of three types. Triangles are of various types. Number one, right angle triangle. So this is equal to area of the right angle triangle. Angle is equal to half base into height. Number two, area of an equilateral triangle. Is equal to root 3 by 4 a square, where a is equal to side of the triangle. Number 3, area of a scalene triangle. That is equal to S. Area is equal to root over S minus A into S minus B into S minus C, and S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. A, B, C are the length of the triangle. So this is about the triangles. So next one which we will move is the figure of a four-sided figure. But before that, we will think about another type of triangle, that is area of a isosceles triangle. Area of an isosceles triangle is equal to b by 4 square root of 4a square minus b square. 4a square minus b square, where b is the base and a is an equal sign, where b is a base and a is the equal sign. Equal side. Now we will move towards the area of the figures having four sides. Area of the figure of a figure of a four sides. Number one, area of a quadrilateral. Number one, area of a quadrilateral whose diagonals bisect at right angles, that is equal to half product of the diagonals, half product of the diagonals. Next, number two, area of a rectangle is equal to base in is equal to length into breadth. Then area of number three, area of a square is equal to length into length, that is equal to length square. Number four, then area of a parallelogram, parallelogram is equal to length of the base into height. Then area of a rhombus, area of a rhombus area of the rhombus is equal to half into product of the diagonals. Number six, area of a trapezium, area of a trapezium area of the trapezium is equal to half sum of parallel sides into height. Half sum of the parallel sides into height. Then the third one is perimeter of a rectangle. Perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2 into L plus B. Perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2 into L plus B. Next one is perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square is equal to Number two is perimeter of a square is equal to 4 into side. Then perimeter of a parallelogram. Number three, perimeter of a parallelogram that is equal to 2 into L plus B. Number 4. Perimeter of a rhombus is equal to 4 into side. Then again, number 5, perimeter of a trapezium, sum of the four sides. Then the next one is about the diagonals. Number four, about the diagonals. Length of the diagonal of a square. Length of a diagonal of a square is equal to root two A, where A is the side, Number two, length of the diagonal of a rectangle. Length of a diagonal of a rectangle is equal to root over L square plus B square. Root over L square plus B square. Then the diagonal length of the diagonal of a cube. Number 3. Length of a diagonal of a cube length of the diagonal of a cube is equal to root 3 a, where a is the side of the cube, Next one, is number 4. Length of the diagonal of a cuboid. That is equal to root over L square plus B square plus H square. L square plus B square plus H square. So the next one is the area of about the circles. Number 5, about the circles. So circles, so what do you mean by circle? Circle is a set of points equidistant from a single point. So the line which is if we join the set of points we will get a circle. So the lines joining the set of points is known as the circumference of the circle. And for example, this is a circle, and if this is a point, this point, this is radius, and the total length, this one is diameter, and the outer line is known as circumference. If R is the radius, and D is the diameter, then D is equal to 2R. And number 1, number 2 is circumference. Circumference is equal to 2πr. Number 3. Area of the circle. Area of the circle is pi r square. Then the next one is the area of a circular ring. Area of a circular ring. What do you mean by ring? Ring is the circle, two circles inscribed in a ring. Area of a ring. So two circles with one center point. These are known as the area between the two concentric circles. That means area between the two concentric circles. This is the radius small r and this is big R. So the area of the ring, area of the ring, is equal to pi big R square minus small r square. Pi big R square minus small r square. Area of the ring. Then next one is the perimeter of a semicircle. Number 5. Perimeter of a semicircle. Perimeter of a semicircle is equal to pi plus 2 into r. Pi plus 2 into r. Number 6. Area of a semicircle. Is equal to 1 by 2 pi r square. 1 by 2 pi r square. Then area of a sector. Number 7. Area of a sector. What do you mean by sector? If this is the circle and this, if this one is theta, then this portion is known as the sector of the circle. Then this portion is known as the sector of the circle. So length of the, if this one is A and this one is B, then length of the arc AB. Length of the arc AB. Arc AB is equal to pi theta by 180. Pi theta by 180 units. 7A. Then 7B. Perimeter of the circle. Perimeter of the sector. Perimeter of the sector is equal to length of the arc. Length of the arc. Length of the arc plus diameter of the circle. Diameter of the circle that is equal to pi theta by 180, pi theta by 180 plus 2r, then area of the circle. Number C, area of the sector. Area of the sector. Area of the sector is equal to pi r square theta by r square theta by 360. Then the next one is about the segment. What do you mean by segment of a circle? Number 8. Segment of a circle. Segment of a circle. So see here. So if this is the circle, then this one is minor segment and this one is major segment. Minor segment and this one is major segment. And this is O, this is O, and this is A, B, and this one is R. A, B, R, and here it is S. So perimeter of the minor segment, number 8, perimeter of a minor segment ACB, perimeter of the minor segment ACB, perimeter of the minor segment ACB is equal to length of the arc plus length of the chord. Length of the arc, length of the arc plus length of the chord, length of the chord. So this is equal to pi theta by 180, pi theta by 180 plus length of the chord, length of the chord. Then area of the minor segment, area of the minor segment, number 9, area of the minor segment, area of the minor segment number 9, area of the minor segment, area of the minor segment is equal to area of the sector, O A C B minus area of the triangle, triangle OAB, that is equal to pi r square theta, by 360, minus 1 by 2 by 360 minus 1 by 2 r square sine theta, this is theta, 1 by 2 r square sine theta. So this is equal to 1 by 2 r square pi theta by 360 minus sine theta. Next one is the area of the major segment. Area of the major segment that is equal to area of the circle minus area of the minor segment. Area of the circle minus area of the minor segment. Area of the circle minus area of the minor segment. So this is equal to, this is equal to pi r square minus pi r square minus pi r square minus pi r square theta pi r square theta by 360 minus 1 by 2 r square sine theta r square sine theta. So this is equal to pi r square minus pi r square theta by 360 plus 1 by 2 r square sine theta. So the next one